Corvex Lair was another level during the vertical slice phase of development. This scene was made to evoke the familiar but always fun scenario you might find in a Dungeons & Dragons campaign. There's an ogre bothering a local town. Go find his dark foreboding cave and kill him. However, with pillars, we always like to subvert the player's expectations where we can. In this instance, you have the trappings of your typical ogre lair, fit with piles of bones and the smell of death. But once you actually encounter Korvac, you quickly learn he's not some dumb creature. He's rather perceptive of your intentions and has his own motivations for stealing Grimbald's pigs. Like many of the creatures in our game, you try to put a different spin on the typical fantasy characterization. Ogres in Aeora are intelligent creatures that, through their own paranoia of others, especially their own kind, live lives of solitude and are prone to agitation and outbursts of anger. Korvac is no different, and we aim to make this conversation with him reflect this. If the player understood this right away and choose to treat the ogre as a rational creature, they will be rewarded with avoiding a rather difficult encounter.
My neighbors.
And what does the flame reveal?
I'm ready.
All right, then.
Leave it to me!
Great, I feel like killing.
Can't move!
Hey.
Craved. Silence surrounds me. Craved.
starting to miss my neighbors.
Sharp eyes and keen ears.
I'm going to guess that whatever lives here gets very, very hungry. Sharp eyes and keen ears.
Of course. Keeping an eye out.
gets me. I'm on the trail. Shadows.
And the fire shall be something new. Let's see what lies this way.
Hello? A simple test. That's settled.
Yes.
All right, then.
The Temple of Escape is an underground dungeon.
We've missed quite the bloody
celebration. That mixed castles, basement, and cells on the west side.
I'll take a look.
With the ruins of an old temple on the east side.
The
first dungeon that we designed for the game. And its original block was even larger, but eventually I trimmed it down to something more manageable. Part of the challenge here was building a seamless transition between the two distinct areas, which also slanted at different angles so as to make them appear more natural. Sean Dunny, one of our environment artists, came up with the idea of having a negative space transition, sort of like the bridge by the chasm that blends those two areas. And he did an amazing job with this render. So much so that one of the locations that we've shown since the very beginning in our backer updates is this very dungeon.
I can do that. That's settled. And the fire shows me something new.
I'm on the trail.
Something over there.
Ready, Watcher.
Hey.
Certainly.
Slowly now.
Lay in low.
Thank you.
You may feel a little lightheaded for the next hour. The transfusion will be smooth subversion. The Black I don't expect you to understand what I'm doing. Neither the Rich did a bit of digging. Lord Heron's been telling everyone she's his daughter. He brought her all. Easy to disbelieve. Heron's own wife's delivered nothing but Hollowborn. Now he's got no heir. This isn't just about Heron to the girl. It's a... I do not wish to destroy Nestor Heron. I wish to end his entire rotten line. His name will become a curse among strangers. The deeds of his house will be eclipsed. It's already done. What is any of this to you? Don't tell me you pity Heron.
Effigy's eyes, do you realize what you've...
Great. Great. Ready, Watcher.
You're not getting through me.
What?
Hey.
Attention to the priest!
All right, then.
Ready, Watcher.
This I haven't seen before.
Thank you.